A new class of risk managers.
The opportunity it gives you, it's nowhere else. You can't find this anywhere else.
RIMS 2015 is working to reach a new generation. Welcome to RIMS TV, sponsored by Liberty Mutual Insurance. I'm Monty Francis. One of the big priorities at RIMS this year is cultivating new talent. And to show you where that talent can take you, we didn't have to look far.
So please welcome the 2015 Risk Manager of the Year, Kathleen Ireland.
Several risk professionals were recognized on Tuesday for their accomplishments, including Kathleen Ireland, VP of Risk Management for IBM, who is named the 2015 Risk Manager of the Year.
I'm very fortunate because I didn't get here on my own. I got here with the help of many, many professionals in the insurance industry, staff at IBM, my team, as well as just encouragement from everywhere. So thank you very much.
Also Tuesday morning, experts weighed in during a State of the Industry panel. Prominent risk managers discussed the need to cultivate a new generation of risk professionals.
There is just going to be so many vacancies in a very short period of time, because as you look around the industry's graying. A lot of people are baby boomers, and the generation immediately behind us is not very strong in terms of numbers.
Panelists agreed that reaching young people with internships, scholarships, and training will be a vital step in making millennials interested in having careers in the field. RIMS is doing its part to reach out to millennials. Students and rising risk professionals were out networking at an early morning breakfast, excited for what the future holds.
We are able to have the networking opportunities with industry leaders as well as other students at different schools. I think this is a once-in-a-lifetime experience, and I'm so happy to be here. Honestly, it's such an honor.
That's good to know that when you graduate, you're going to have a job afterwards.
The opportunity for people entering the risk management or the insurance industry, it's a great time. There's a lot of aging in our industry, so it presents a lot of great opportunities for people who are entering this part of their career right now.
Recognizing the opportunities for up-and-coming professionals was just one of the many things discussed at Tuesday's Hot Topic Session, a senior executive forum on game-changing issues in the industry.
Cyber liability is in the top of their minds, and I think that's very important, especially in light of the recent news that we've been looking at Target and different hackings that have been going on. And also, I think the last one would be predictive analytics and the use of big data to get new opportunities within your business.
Are you ready for the next big disaster? Well, today's emergency response planning session explored the complexities of flood risk, how to minimize aggregated loss, and recover faster. You can better prepare by identifying if you're in a flood zone, assessing that risk, and reviewing flood protection options available online at FEMA.org.
It's going to be a combination of what we call hard fixes and soft fixes, where you actually, the hard fixes are you provide the barriers, permanent barriers to prevent flooding, and then the soft fixes is where the areas that you can't or you can't afford to permanently protect, then the soft fixes are temporary emergency response type fixes that you can come in.
Another emerging trend is the use of e-health.
So it really covers a lot of areas. It can include the dissemination of information through electronic health records, health information exchanges, as well as patient portals that are popping up now.
These new modalities of healthcare come with their own risk, including licensure, patient privacy and data security, and medical malpractice. One of the best ways to mitigate risk in these situations is to learn the regulatory landscape in each state. to effectively apply e-health into the delivery of care. Risk managers are also sharpening their negotiating skills here at RIMS 2015. Experts walked attendees through a case settlement scenario involving an insurance claim. They explained the do's and don'ts of any negotiation.
One of the big negotiating mistakes people make is being impatient. They'll go from their first offer to their final offer, one step. And so if you do that, you've lost all your leverage. So you've got to be patient. And the other thing I think people make mistakes is they talk too much. You've got to listen to what the other side says, gather information. The more you listen, the better off you're going to be.
Don't be afraid of it. Be prepared. Make sure that you pre-plan, have your goals, and just do your homework.
Also on Tuesday, the premiere of Bermuda came to RIMS 15. Premier Michael Dunkley visited with RIMS Executive Director Mary Roth and RIMS President Rick Roberts and posed for some photos. Mr. Dunkley told us why RIMS is an important annual event for the British territory.
We live in a very competitive world, and when you live in a competitive world that changes as quickly as it does, you have to continue to spread your message. And with Bermuda being a small player in the world market, we're a very important player, and we want to continue to show what Bermuda has to offer.
On the other side of the exhibit hall, attendees got a chance to give back to the community as part of Zurich's community outreach project. Attendees didn't even have to leave the exhibit floor, helping to fill backpacks with food that will be delivered to children in need in the New Orleans area. A nonprofit group called Blessings in a Backpack coordinated the event. An exciting final day is still ahead for RIMS 2015. There's still many more education sessions on the way, and don't forget the closing keynote address from Arianna Huffington. Also, don't forget to pick up your final copy of the RIMS 15 Show Daily. It is the only official daily publication distributed at this year's conference. For now, I'm Monty Francis with RIMS TV, sponsored by Liberty Mutual Insurance.